Hello there, Versador here. I'm out here on the Ting, the big Ting, with my good friend Stuart Hill. Right. We're going to take over the world, isn't that right, Mr. Hill?
Absolutely right, yes.
Absolutely right. I've known you for quite a time.
Since almost the first time I arrived here, it's 2001, yes.
You were one of a lot of people say that you're just a crazy man, but I know what I mean, I'm a crazy man and everything, and nothing wrong with being crazy, but I think that you just think a little differently from other people.
Well, actually, that's the first thing I say when I talk to people on the doorstep. Hello, I'm Stuart Hill. I'm the crazy man in the election. But yeah. I'm not as crazy as you might think.
Not as crazy as me. Yeah. But I think anybody that stands up to authority, because although in Shetland we're not very good at standing up to authority, we still have a little anti-authoritarian streak.
Oh, absolutely. I'm sure the Viking blood is there.
Rawr.
Yeah. And I want to raise the Viking blood.
Raise the Viking blood here on the Ting.
I want to get rid of a 550-year-old injustice and do something about it.
Yeah.
It can't be done in a week, but I think I've been saying for ages that when this change happens, it'll come at such a speed that we'll all be caught by surprise, and I believe this is it. Here it comes.
Yeah. But it's going to depend on every Shetlander standing up against these tyrants. They're everywhere. And releasing that inner anti-authoritarian genome.
We are actually living under a lot of bullies. We don't realise it, but the iron fist is only just
below. Poor Shetlanders were treated so bad.
Yeah. Yeah,
by the layers back in the day.
It's still in the Shetland psyche.
Yeah, that's why I'm here. But how are we so...
Poor thing.
My poor thing. I'm a poor thing. a lot of people think you're just crazy, but I appreciate this out-of-the-box thinking. Mm. I like this different way of looking at things. It's, if everybody in Shetland got together behind you and went to the polling station and voted,
you've got the wrong tents. You've got the wrong tents.
Oh, okay. When everybody in Shetland goes to the polling station and votes for Mr. Hill, and when you are elected, what's going to happen then, Stuart? What's going to happen?
Well, we wake up on Friday morning, we own the land, we own the sea, we own the seabed. Out to 200 miles.
I get to be king.
Pardon?
Sorry.
Don't say anything.
200 miles, right? Oh,
yeah.
Yeah. Oh boy.
The legal work is already done.
I don't even have a yawl.
The government doesn't dispute it. Neither the Scottish or the UK government disputes this idea.
No.
They've got nothing to say. All they can come up with in the courts is a magazine article. It's just ludicrous. But the other thing they rely on is that we keep sending a representative down to the Parliament.
Oh, yeah, that's important.
So every time we send somebody down, they laugh up their sleeve and think, here we go again, well done, off we go.
Yeah.
They've got no authority, but every time we send an MP, we give them that authority.
So this time...
So right now, they don't have it.
No, because there's
no MPs.
There's no MPs.
And I have absolutely no intention of going down and pledging allegiance to a foreign occupying power.
No.
Which means that immediately the power stays here and we become our own people straight away.
Mm-hmm. What happens if they tell you have to go down or else you'll have to have a by-election?
They're no good. Well, what are they going to do? Send in the gunboats?
Probably.
Yeah.
Hey, there's a whole pile of swans.
Yeah.
Oh yes, we got a question on Facebook. If you get elected, is it going to be open season on swans?
Oh, I don't know about that.
We can eat the swans.
That's the kind of question that it's not up to me to tell the people of Shetland about anything.
Any law.
Nothing at all.
Like you said,
it's up to the people of Shetland to decide what, and Orkney of course, to decide what they want.
And you said you were just opening a door. You've shown us the door.
Yeah.
There's been an injustice a long time ago, but it's still
I'm not
there.
Here to be your leader.
No.
No.
No, I'm the leader.
Yeah.
My God. And when you get elected, so that you said there's not going to be much change happening. Immediate
no.
Big change.
Well, just the same way as the UK is leaving the EU. There's no great big change at that event.
Yeah.
We simply take on, well, they will simply take on board the existing EU laws, make them part of British law, and change them as they see fit. We will do exactly the same process, but we will do it, I would like to see it done in a much more radical way, so that the law, in essence, is harm nobody.
Yeah.
And all our laws have to be brought into line with that single concept.
Yeah. And you're looking for a whole new, different way to
Run a society.
To run a society,
yeah.
So like a fairer, better society.
Yeah. This election is so important because the whole world is watching. I had an article in the New York Times 3 weeks ago. I've had a Belgian television crew following me last week, an English one this week. The world is watching what we do because this is so important. This little bit of the world, when we do what we're going to do, which is make a fair society, will ripple out to the rest of the world like a virus. And there's two changes that have to be made to make it work. First of all, the electoral system, that we have an election, the first and the last. After that, it's a continuous process. Each candidate...
This is a vision for a new society.
Yeah. And I found nobody that would disagree with it so far.
No, I've heard. Okay. Sounds great.
So each candidate keeps the votes they get. Instead of chucking them in the bin, as we do at the moment, each candidate keeps the votes they get.
Right.
But they can be taken away from them. You can remove your vote from that candidate anytime you like.
Yeah.
So the person in office, instead of being there comfortably for 5 years doing whatever they like, has got to keep looking over their shoulder and think, am I doing what the people want me to do?
Yeah, and is this at a council level?
Any level of public officialdom, if you like. Anyone who thinks themselves as a public servant. And the second thing is, the most important thing is to get rid of positions of power. Every society suffers from positions of power.
Yeah.
Wherever you've got a position of power,
you've got
a tyrant to occupy it.
Mm-hmm. Psychopath.
Yeah.
Narcissist.
Absolutely. So, and that results from the way that we handle our money. The government raises taxes. All that money is pooled in one place. You've got a massive concentration of power.
Yeah.
So what you have to do is say, right, we agree amongst ourselves, and this is why this kind of size of society is so important. You can't do this on a big national scale.
No.
It has to be done on a small scale.
Yeah.
We decide amongst ourselves the amount of our income, the percentage of our attention, will you?
Sorry, I'm right here.
The percentage of our
income. You're talking to them, right? I can't also.
Yeah. The percentage of our income which will be put towards the running of the society.
Yes. And the individual gets to choose where their money is spent.
That's exactly it.
Spent.
So then, having made that decision, the percentage, so people with a small income pay a small amount, people with a big income pay a large amount. Then each individual decides where they want to put that money.
Yeah, yeah.
So that, for instance, young people might want to put it into Mareel or something silly like that.
Really? Yes, young people would like things, music.
Or they might want to put it in the
old
maternity department.
Old folks' homes. Bingo clubs.
And nearly everybody wants to put something into the roads.
The roads, yeah.
Or,
the roads.
You know, so that you make your own personal decision about where your money goes.
Sounds fantastic.
So that cuts out
vote
all
for
the middlemen.
He's got,
all the tyrants. Mm-hmm. Now, if you can imagine that being done throughout the world, as soon as this is kind of released out into the world, any of those tyrants, whether they be in a communist nation, a fascist or capitalist, whateverist you want, mm-hmm. once the support is removed from the bottom, they will fall.
Yeah.
I would like to see the whole world as a complete mosaic of communities of this kind of size, cooperating together for their mutual advantage. But without the possibility of even having war, it's never the people that want the war, it's only the big governments, big business, big banking, those that profit from it and engineer the circumstances for it to happen.
Yeah. We want a peaceful society.
Yeah. Let's have a unilateral declaration of peace.
Peace, yeah. And if people would be concerned that if we just became independent without a backup, then we would be vulnerable. But
what I'm saying is that I've been saying this for years, that this change will happen so quickly that we'll all be taken by surprise. And the change is from 1% of the population of the world owning half of its wealth to that being, we live in a world of abundance, but it's been cornered by those few people.
It's not just about Shetland, it's about the world.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
I think it will break out so quickly that the possibility of war will just be eliminated.
Yeah. So, yeah. Okay. Right.
It'll just be like a computer virus. Just ripple out.
We're declaration of peace. We're making ourselves. We're trying to find the true.
Isn't this
peaceful nature of
isn't
the human
this a silly
being?
Thing to be talking about? You know, isn't it just surreal to even think that we could be here changing the world? Isn't it just absolutely surreal?
I've been wanting to do it for years. I mean, I've smelled a rat for so long, I've become immune.
But nothing has deterred me. I've been working on this almost since I came here.
Yeah.
I've been in the courts for 6 years trying to get the government to show how it's got any authority here. And it comes down to this magazine article. Yeah. It's just ludicrous. But I don't go away.
No, I know you, Stuart, from back in the day. And then if you didn't think you were right this thing. And
they would have come up with a document and said, here it is, Mr. Hill. There's the document. There's the date. Go away.
You would have given up long ago.
Yeah. But they've resorted to such underhand tactics. I found judges at every level in the Scottish court system willing to break the law and ignore their own rules, simply not to have that question asked in the courts. Even the latest two cases I've got, I'm prohibited from challenging the jurisdiction of the court.
Yeah,
that's a fundamental human right.
Yeah.
I even got a backdated prison sentence for contempt of court without even a trial. You wouldn't expect that in a third world country.
Yeah.
It's, you know, you don't see it in the press because the press are like any other Shetlander. They sit there and they think, well, this show's all right. He knows what he's doing. Must be all right.
Yeah.
No notice. You know, nothing reported in the press.
Mm-hmm.
Just, it's beyond me.
So where you're coming from is an injustice a long time ago.
Yeah.
There is a question mark over where Shetland is, who Shetland belongs to and all this. But so you're going to utilise that to make it, would like to utilise that, and we are going to utilise that to make a fairer society and a new paradigm for democracy on a global scale.
But let me put the whole thing in. So if you walk down the street and you ask somebody, do they think they're above the Queen here? They just look at you as if you're mad. But that really is the case. And I want to get away from all of that. I want to raise the Viking blood again and get people to back what I'm doing. As I said, I have absolutely no intention of going down and pledging allegiance to this foreign power. I want to get rid of the bullies. I want to put Shetland back in the hands of the people of Shetland. What it means is that on June the 9th, having woken up to owning the land, the sea and the seabed, it means that the fisheries and agriculture that everybody is so worried about being on the table, on the Brexit negotiating table, ready to be used as bargaining chips because they mean nothing to Westminster, but they mean an awful lot up here, that agriculture and fisheries come off the table. It's not theirs to bargain with, it's ours.
Yeah.
And I'm the only candidate in this election who can say that. The others all say, well, we'll do our best, we'll try and mitigate it, but I'm saying off the table.
Yeah,
nothing to do with that. And the other thing is,
great,
we get an extra £82 million. Extra.
I get an extra £82 million.
Well, you get about £8,200 as one of the Shetland households.
How much do I get?
£8,200.
Oh boy.
Roughly 10,000 households.
I could buy a new car.
Yeah. Or anything.
Yes.
So there's 82,000
pounds. Go to Amsterdam for a month.
And that results from the fact that at the moment, when we send all our direct and indirect taxes down to the government, they give us back all the grants and subsidies we need to run the place.
Yeah.
But after that process, there's 82 million pounds left in the UK Treasury every year. So we could have free ferries, we could stop closing rural schools, we could do all the things we want to do. And this is even before you start talking about the oil money.
Yeah, well.
Everybody says, well, it's running out. They've just found the biggest field ever.
Biggest lump of oil ever.
And although the price has dropped right down, the figures are so huge, it's beyond belief. When the price was up, there was £50 billion worth of oil going through the terminal every year. This is not gas, this is just the oil. That's 50,000 million pounds. Now, can you imagine that?
No, I can't. No. Sorry, frankly, right. Frankly, I can't.
So, of that, the government took 20%, which is 10,000 million pounds. The price has dropped maybe by two-thirds, so we're only talking about 3,300 million pounds.
Okay.
You know, it's inconceivable figures. We couldn't possibly use that money, but that should be our foreign aid to the UK, or wherever else we want to send it, if we don't like the fact that they spend it on illegal wars, bailing out banks and MPs' expenses, yeah, duck houses and whatever, then we should send it somewhere else. But it should be up to us.
I get a duck house?
Oh, absolutely.
Wow. Duck houses for all.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Great.
Isn't it good?
It is, yeah.
Yeah.
And so we want the... Yes.
So all you have to do is...
What do we have to do, Stuart? What do we have to do?
Go down to the ballot box, put your cross against Hill. And it was such a delight for me when I did my postal vote, because I'll be down at the count, so I won't
be
here.
Right.
I got a postal vote to put my cross against my name. Right. Oh, that was just super.
Well, that answers the question. Somebody asked, if you're going to vote on Thursday, you've
already
done the postal vote.
I've done it, yeah.
And put your cross.
Yeah. And also, when the election was announced, I got an email from Ladbrokes announcing that they were giving odds on all the different candidates. So I looked up my name, 100-1, right.
Wait a minute here, guys, come on, heads up.
100-1, so I put the maximum, what do you call it?
Maximum
bet on it,
right,
which was 20 quid. So, £2,000 coming my way.
Yeah. And we could all have £2,000 coming our way when we vote Hill.
Next
is
morning.
This legal? Of course it's legal, there's no legal jurisdiction.
Next morning, they'd taken all those 100-1 votes off.
Really?
You couldn't get it anymore.
No. Oh, God. Why?
But I got mine in. I've got my...
Why have they taken that off?
Well, it was too risky for them.
Too risky?
Yeah.
Oof. Okay. So, right. So, it's not just about this election. It's about a new society, a new system, a new way of looking. How's your man for looking outside the box? Is that the right phrase, looking outside the box?
Oh, yes, absolutely, yes. I don't like boxes.
Yeah,
keep outside.
And you've been doing it all your life. Like,
yeah.
I remember when you worked when we were working at Adams & Brothers, like, you're making different tools that made the job easier. Stuart can make your life easier.
Mm, yes. Well, I used to be a blacksmith, and the first thing you learn as a blacksmith is do things quickly. Strike while the iron's hot.
Strike while the iron's hot, yeah.
And that's what this is all about.